Hi everyone, it's Happy Mail Queen. Today I have a project for my crafty boutique. I was playing with some of the digital images and I decided I wanted to create some embellishments before making a bigger project. And as some of you guys may know who follow me, I made some embellishments with chipboard. I was inspired by Tony, who is Craft Purge, and she had made chipboard pieces, and she attached charms on them. She put holes and used eyelets, and she put charms on them. And I just love that look, so plan to make those kind of embellishments more often. So I thought I would do it with this digital kit from Crafty Boutique. So the digital collection that I was talking about is the Monster Bash, and these are the elements that I decided to print out. I did shrink them down a little bit, and I printed them on some matte sticker sheets, and then I had also put I think a couple of them I did glossy accents, and I also did some stickling. And you guys, I did this on my Cricut Maker, and I was able to make chipboard embellishments. I have lots of chipboard. I have a medium weight chipboard, and I really wanted to try it out to see if my Cricut Maker can actually cut little, you know, small embellishments or these. So I put it through and it did it. I mean, I was so excited. You have no idea how excited I was, because now I want to make my own chipboard stickers. I think it's going to be so fun, and I can size it any which way I want. And it does take time though. So I haven't seen anybody do that with their Cricut. I'm sure someone has figured it out. Someone who's, you know, more experienced with the Cricut Maker. But you guys, medium weight chipboard, it cuts through like butter. It just takes time because it goes through so many passes, you know, to cut that thick a material. But your Cricut Maker can do it, okay? And let me show you what I created. Okay, so here it is. Let me show you one by one. I'm just going to be picking them up as I go along, and you can kind of see it a little better here on my hand. So as you can see, look how thick it is. It is thick. Okay, I mean, not like super thick, but it's great. So what I did was I printed the image on my sticker paper, and then I also took the cut file, the file that had just the, you know, the cut on it. I don't know if I'm explaining that right, but it just cuts like the silhouette, and I made sure I sized that with my images, sized it the same so that it would cut the chipboard. And then I layered the sticker on top of the chipboard, and I also used some glue. And I'll show you my process actually at the end of the video, because I think you can appreciate it better. So that's one. Here's another one here. I love this little Polaroid, and I just added charms. I made a hole with is it 1/8 inch setting? And then I used some of my 1/8 inch, what are these? Eyelets. So I put eyelets on all of them, and then just used some jump rings and just added my little bead dangles. So there's one. Oh my gosh, this is one of my favorites. Do you guys see the moon and stars? It is so cute. This is the spell book. How adorable is that? And as you can see, I stickled. And I think this is the vinyl. It's a little bit glossy, but not that glossy. I don't know if you can see that. But it is actually vinyl paper. And then this little piece right here, you guys, I made this using my mold. I was just experimenting, and I used one of these molds right here. The little molds that I had gotten from BB Craft, I made the stars and the moon. And not with resin, okay? It's actually better with resin because then it will come out really nice and sturdy or hard. I actually used my Nuvo drops because, and my enamel. I also did that. But this one, I think it's just the Nuvo drops. I added a little bit of glossy accents because it did crack a little bit right here because I made a hole. And so I had to add glossy accent to actually glue it back because it kind of split. But it still looks cute, I think. So anyway, that's because I didn't have a moon charm. So there's that one. So I'll just go over these quickly. And this is another chipboard. Aren't they cute? Here's one. I love this cupcake. So cute. And so I'm not sure what I'm gonna do yet with it. So we'll see. I mean, I'm obviously gonna put it on a project, but we'll see. Cause like some of them, like look at this pom pom from what is that? From BB Craft. And look at my little charm right here. It's so cute. I think that's from Hobby Lobby, if I'm not mistaken. Think it's this one right here, and my little ghosty charms are so cute. I got those last year online, I think on Amazon. And let's see, this one is really simple here. I just used this, not sure where I got that tassel, but there you go. Monster Jams. It is so cute. And then here's another rip. This one here, I glossied the whole thing with glossy accent. So after I had put my sticker on the chipboard, then I just put glossy accents and stickled the bottom here. But oh my gosh, those are cute. I had so much fun. I hope I showed you everything, but there it is. So stay tuned for more projects from me. And if you want to stick around, I do have a process video that I'll probably just speed up so you guys can see what I did when I made the chipboard. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys later.